funny you should say that.
Well, over here. You know how it is. I told him. I say, that's the state of Lemoyne for
hey,
you.
Hey, can I get
America's
a drink here?
Dirty little French secret.
And that's why we love it.
Born and raised. Well, I'm sorry. Please excuse me. I seem to have some very impatient customers. Now, how can I help? You look like a whiskey man.
Sure.
Dollar, please.
For a whiskey?
Sure. That's the real stuff. From Scotland.
Okay. Here, have one for yourself.
Why, thank you.
So, mister, can I ask you a question? You ever hear of a fella by the name of Bronte?
Who's asking?
Me. I'm asking.
No, leave it, Fred.
What do you mean, leave it?
Look, I don't know what business you in, but leave it, Fred. You and your pal that was in here before.
Bronte? Angelo Bronte. Mr. Big, Mr. Italian, spaghetti-eating, long streak of piss big. Yeah, he makes my skin crawl. I'm so squally a cocksucker. You know what I mean, friend?
Where can I find him?
Oh, well, I reckon you talk to them kids in the alley, they'll know, I guess. Oh, hey, friend, you be careful now. Immigrants, they're not to be trusted.
Good morning, you hear?
It's really become quite the prank.
So you just walk up to any man with a ring on his finger and turn it three times?
Yes. And then after 24 men, find any married person, male or female, wearing a wedding ring, turn that ring twice, and then the next man you shake hands with will become your husband.
What nonsense.
Don't take my word for it then.
Hey, you got a cigarette, mister?
Maybe.
Huh?
I'm looking for a fellow named Angelo Bronte, Italian.
I know him. Everyone knows him.
Where is he?
We'll take you to him. What it'll cost?
I reckon I can pay.
$5.
Where does he live? New York?
I'm an entrepreneur. If you don't want to pay, then I don't want to walk.
Oh, man. That's a bad bread. Here. Come on.
This away. Let's go, mister. You coming, Cleet? Stay close. Easy to get lost around here. Come on, then. You new to the city, mister?
Pretty much.
Don't worry. No one knows it as good as me and Cleet.
Is that right?
Hope you won't need his services, but you got the doctor on the corner there. Nice enough, fella. That's Baird and Schreiber on the right there. Famous bookstore. Not that I'm much of a reader myself. Now over here's a real piece of art. That's the Church of the Holy Blessed Virgin, mister. Modeled on the famous church in Toulouse, which is in France. You been to Toulouse, mister?
No.
We're Catholics here, mister. Ain't Baptist or nothing.
My mama said they used to burn Protestants and all, but.
Bet they don't have nothing so fine where you come from, mister. Look at them fine steeples.
Hey, you little pair of shits.
Let's go. That fellow looks angry.
Stop, goddammit.
Ain't you tired yet, old man?
Hey! Oh! back here. You give that back.
You ain't got a chance in hell, Slowpoke.
I'll kill you, thieving bastard.
Just give it up, farm boy.
Just give it up, kid.
Watch your step.
Fine, Mark.
I'm telling you, a cucumber is definitely a fruit.
Since when?
Since forever. I read it in the newspaper. Yeah.
Oh, so it must be true.
Friend,
give me my things, boy.
What are you talking about, friend?
I ain't your friend, but that kid is, and he robbed from me. Now give me back my stuff and take me to Angelo Bronte.
Senor Bronte.
The kid was gonna show me before he robbed me. Now, come on.
You new in town, mister?
Come on.
Mr. Bronte's got a lot of friends, mister, but I ain't never seen you.
We ain't friends.
You don't like no one, mister. Mr. Bronte, he's got fine hair. He got a beautiful house, and I am proud to work for him. He got 50 men, mister. Why he gonna care a thing about you?
I just wanna speak with him.
I'm sure you do, mister. You and them friends of yours been asking about him all over town. He's been mighty disrespected. Bunch of muddy Yankees in town asking questions. Well, you and your friend should pay him a visit, mister. He's got a big house on Flavian Street opposite the park.
Hey, yokel.
Now, get out of here.
Where you been?
Getting robbed?
Who by?
Bunch of children.
I won't inquire anymore.
But I found Mr. Bronte. Seems to be some Italian Mr. Big in town. Everybody knows him, but nobody wants to talk about him. Apparently lives in a big house on Flavian Street opposite the park.
Good work.
So what now?
We go pay him a visit. I'll get John, you meet us there. Whatever it takes, we need to get that boy back.
I cannot decide which I like less, the swamps or the city. Both are full of parasites, reptiles, and slime. We're a long way each to land we know, and far from real open country.
For a minute of your time?
Excuse me.
There you are.
You boys ready?
Of course. What else do you know about this guy?
Not much, just he's some slick little greasy-haired European who's clearly got power and money. Now, listen. If we go in there and start shooting up a place, the boy's gonna get shot, that I guarantee. Better like this, he's gonna have a lot of protection.
Ain't no one gonna get shot, Arthur, so everyone just relax. We'll charm him. Trust me. This the place?
Must be.
You okay, John? I guess.
Excuse me, sir. We have an appointment to see Mr. Bronte.
Who are you?
You get your boss down here and now so we can talk about this like gentlemen.
Run along now, boy.
Is that the special Dutch charm I heard so much about?
Relax. I got this.
Don't worry, boys. We come in peace.
We just need to straighten a couple of things out with your boss.
Chi sono sti buffoni?
Sono qui per Picciotto.
Coi soldi?
Why do you take his son?
Excuse me.
I said, why did you take his son? We ain't got no problems with you, sir. Nor you with us. But if you want to start one, there's gonna be a lot of folks dead in this room before it's done.
So, you walk into my city, stinking of shit and looking like this, and you come into my house before you have a bath and you tell me how to act? You ask me to show compassion. Have I not shown you almost infinite compassion already by simply allowing you to breathe in my presence?
Indeed you have. Now, we are simple
country folk. All we have is each other. And you have gone and you have took his son over some dispute with some inbred ex-slavers. It ain't got nothing to do with any one of us.
You had nothing to do with destroying the liquor business.
We was innocent bystanders. And that which we weren't innocent of, well, we most surely were ignorant of.
You twist words. You lie shamelessly. You think you are better than everyone else. Diodoro. Date da beresti uomini. Angelo Bronte.
Dutch Vanderlyn. Arthur Morgan.
Arthur, the pleasure is mine.
John Marston.
All mine, please.
So, can my friend have his son?
Of course, of course. But should I be out of pocket over a misunderstanding? Of course I know you would not want that, huh?
No.
No. So how about this? You perform a simple job for me, and you get your son back.
What is it?
A couple of people have taken to grave robbing in the cemetery.
Well, that is a fine place for it, the best.
I love this guy. I love you. See, they've taken not only to desecrating the dead, but they've done so without paying a tribute to the living. Thing is, they see my men, of course they're on a mile, so maybe you two head off, huh? And you, Mr. van der Linde, why you tell me more about my manners. Salute.
Salute.
You all right, girl?
Grave robbers? You think he's taking us for a fool?
No idea. What choice do we have?
None, I guess. This is idiotic.
You know where the cemetery is?
I think so. Pretty sure I rode by it earlier. It's real impressive.
You know, you did good holding your tongue in there.
Do you trust one word that comes out of that bastard's mouth? We don't even know where Jack is.
Listen, we found Bronte. We got in there. Dutch is with him now. All things considered, it could have gone a lot worse.
That poor kid. I ain't been a good father to him. I hope he's okay.
He'll be fine. I figure the Braithwaites were going to hold Jack ransom for all the money we cost him. They must have sent him here so we couldn't get to him. But Bronte knows by now there's no Braithwaites left to pay him. Jack ain't much use to him anymore. Let's just get this done. Let Dutch handle the rest.
I just hope you're right. Okay. I think this is it. Keep it down. Let's hitch your horses up ahead. This way. Come on. Let's find him and get the hell out of here. Keep it down. Don't want him to bolt on us. Thank you.
Someone already cleaned this one out.
Can't believe we're doing this.
I know, but you won't care once we get the boy back.
That bastard better keep his word. Stay quiet. We don't want to spook him. Been on some strange jobs, Morgan, but this one. Where are these sons of bitches? I thought today was gonna turn out. This sure weren't one of them. Hey, John. Over here. You boys found my pappy's watching!
Okay, but we'll need to be quick.
We can't go back to Bronte empty-handed. Let's have a look where they first shot at us from.
Robbing grave robbers. We've hit the big time.
We can't go back to Bronte with nothing to show for it, Arthur.
Think there might be something in here. Got it.
Good. Now let's get out of here. Shit, it's the law. Let's go. Maybe we can get up.
Locked.
Let's just track back to where we came in. Shit, it's the law. Let's go. Maybe we can get out that gate.
Let's go.
shot! Let's just track back to where we came in.
Damn it!
Let's go around the side. stick with me.
Let's go, bro.
Let's get this done.
I ain't a religious man.
Let's just get back there, collect our side of the deal.
Well, you took your time. Where's your host?
Like I said, you took your time. I'm glad to see you.
Let's get going. What a fine man. Hey, friend, thank Mr. Bronte. For
right.
Everything.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Come on.
You know, Arthur, Mr. Bronte has invited us to a garden party at the mayor's house. And us, just simple country boys.
Let's go! We have a new camp set up, Jack. You're gonna love it.
All right, let's get this boy back to his mother.
You sure you're okay, son?
I'm fine. Papa Bronte said you'd come for me.
I'm sorry.
What for?
For that. For taking so long.
I had a fun time. I had my own room with a big bed and a toy box. And lots of books.
Did they do anything to you?
Have you ever had spaghetti?
What? What's that?
It's food. It looks like worms, but it's delicious.
Is that right?
Papa Bronte taught me lots of Italian words.
Don't call him that, please.
You know, cavallo? That means horse. And pantofola? That's a slipper.
A slipper?
They gave me two pairs, one for day and one for night.
Well, I'm just glad you're all right.
Oh, yes. I had the best time, but I can't wait to see Mama. Did she miss me?
She sure did. Like you wouldn't know.
You had a nice night then?
Most enjoyable. Well, the man's an intolerable blowhard, but he stocks a fine bar. How did you fellers get on? Any problems?
A whole heap of them. We about doubled the population of that graveyard.
You know, I thought I heard gunshots, but the gramophone was playing.
Unbelievable.
Each to their strengths, Arthur. I went in there with a gun and left with a party invitation.
So, what'd you say this was? A garden party?
A big gala at the mayor's house. I'm told every rich fool in Lemoyne will be there.
Bronte?
Oh, he'll be there too. Seems to more or less run this city. At least, that's the way he sees it. Could open up some opportunities for us. It's been a chaotic few days.
but we can finally move forward now.
Hey, they're back! I think I see Jack!
Abigail! Abigail! We got you, your son, everything!
We got him!
Mama!
He's fine!
I'm fine, Mama. They fed me good. Italian food. You ever eat that?
Come here, you silly boy. You got him. You got my son back. Dutch, Arthur, thank you. Thank you. I got my son back.
Jack. How are you, boy?
I'm fine, thanks.
Everything's okay now. Abigail?
Can I go play now?
So?
Well, we met Mr. Bronte. He is quite a character.
Is he now?
You ever meet an Italian strong man before?
Not outside of a circus.
Well, let me tell you all about him. John, you go be with your family. Arthur, thank you. Boys, we got some work to do. Interesting work. But first, let's have a drink. We got Jack back!
Well... Boy's safe, thank goodness.
Thank you, Arthur. I don't know how to say it. Thank you.
I understand. Come on. Do as Dutch says. Go be with your family.
Make some room for John there.
Come on, are we celebrating?
You all right, Charles? Yeah, just taking it all in. Loitering suspiciously as usual.
I'm just trying to give you all your moment.
Wow, very kind.
Not really in the mood.
Okay, I'll catch you later then.
I need to be alone.
to take him again. I swear. So, I was thinking, maybe it would be a little easier for me to keep an eye on him if we all stayed together. You know, in my room.
You mean like a normal family?
Look around you. Ain't nothing normal about any of this. Take this fella for one.
Man don't just change like the wind, Abigail. I thought you'd have known that by now.
No, Arthur. Some folks change. Others is just too dumb.
Hey.
Hello.
Hey, fellas.
Hello, Mr. Morgan.
Maybe there is damnation. But I think I know what that'll be like.
Come on, Kieran, join in.
Oh, no, I'm okay, thank you. I'll just watch.
Suit yourself, then.
See it for what the hell it is.
We did it.
Yes, we did.
Thank God. Okay, well, let's talk more later.
Okay, Arthur.
I've said that I'm sorry.
Count yourself real lucky. Well, I should get back to it.
Yeah, it was good talking to you.
Loved ones. A plan. It is a real plan.
Happy, Miss Grimshaw?
Very. Well done, Arthur.
Let's have some fun.
Our own heaven! Tahiti! Fiji! Australia! The real new world! Not this godforsaken dump that all of Europe's detritus has acted out its vengeance on! We are gonna be free! Free.
You okay?
Clearly not. It's getting very tiresome.
Yeah, she seems pretty worked up. You awake yet?
What? Arthur. What is it?
I've forgotten what it was now.
Save it for the morning.